My name is Laszlo Lang. In a Hebrew name, the Tzvi Lang. I am 85 today. I am a machinist. I learned my profession in 1940. And for this time, I working always the machine shop. Art, that's my blood. I believe it is from my mother, because we are young children, and we are not economy too good, and we are needed some satsua, why you say this?
Some games.
Some game to play.
Toys.
My mother went out on pick up from 2-piece wood and put it together. He bended this thing, and after 10 minutes, she's sewing. He was very good sewing, working sewing machine, closet on this. And after a half hour, I had a doll. And I went to the army someday and asked the profession. Some people was driving, some people woodworker, the machinist. I said, machinist, oh, you are a machinist, you have to go to Helayam Navy. We have a big Maspena, big building on people needed from you. When an old man, she liked me. Always she need a help. Laszlo, come and help me. I go to the help always. One day, she said, I want to teach you something. Up to you. Take a piece of copper, sheet metal copper. We cut it, when it stand beside, and look at what you cut it. You cut it something, after take a hammer, and start to benching and thing, who made a rosa.
A rose?
Yeah, well, bend it to back, and put it a screw from
metal.
He saved me. He opened for mine, and I never seen how you make roses from a piece of metal so fast, so beautiful.
We were going in the street, he said, look what people are throwing out. From this, you know, piece of metal that it was scrap. He said, I can do this, I see something here, I see a tree, I see an animal, I see a person, I see a flower, I see this. And from simple scrap, he could do beautiful things.
I look at a face. First, I made the face. If a face good, I can a body make very easy to everything. Not a body after a face, no. First, a face.
Because all what he went through, from the wartime especially. If sometimes I go to see him working, he's so absorbed with his work, he doesn't see me, he doesn't hear me. You know, he's so into his work that the better is to leave him by himself. He's completely concentrated. He doesn't eat, he doesn't drink, he does nothing. That's therapy.
If I going to do something, I see this product ready before I started. If I not see ready, I not started this thing. Art, that's my blood.
My name is Joe Rosenthal. Art is my business. It's a long story, being 89 years old. I was born in Romania, in the city of Chisinau. I apparently had a gift for drawing, and this was encouraged by my parents and other people who saw my work, even at the age of 5 or 6. I began with drawing in classroom, drawing employing crayons or pencil and so on. Later on, that moved to painting, watercolor, things of that nature. Gradually, when I became more professional, I was able to also move into sculpture. All of these were forms of the same expression of figurative creativity. When I paint or am involved in creative work, I feel very engrossed in what I'm doing. I have to remember what I'm drawing. Remember the figures that I had learned from models, and I now learn gradually to do these figures from memory alone. I could see a figure, they don't stand still, and they don't act like models. Therefore, I have to take one look, remember it, and get it down on paper as soon as possible. Eventually, I could paint figures without the use of models. And that gave me more confidence. It gave me strength and conviction in the, what I was doing, and also a satisfaction, a great deal of satisfaction in what I was doing. The consequences was gradually the development of a more professional work. I moved gradually into the realm of Holocaust, the medium that best expresses this. I found the best medium was primarily black and white, and I used color on occasions to portray the cremation that took place, the burning of live people and so on. Can it be really done without some expression of the fire? And I spent time trying to deal with the subject of the Holocaust, which was very challenging for me, and trying to portray the subject as in a creative way, and still make the subject as distasteful, as horrible, and so on, as it really was in real life. I knew that was actually impossible to do in a mere picture or painting, but it still inspired to see how close I could get to it. We have to learn as much as possible about the Holocaust, how it started, why it started, and therefore be in a better position to ensure that it never happened again.